Thank you, everybody, for watching Political Vigilante. My name is Graham Elwood. I'm joined here by Nick Brana. Please hit the like button and share and subscribe and do all that. I wanted to talk to you, Nick, about the future of the People's Party and what is your, like, goals? Like, what are you guys, like, how are you going to roll this out? Because obviously you've seen... You know, so, I mean, I was hoping you guys were going to get like have a candidate for 2020. I was hoping it was going to be Jesse Ventura, quite honestly. But what's the strategy here going into the midterms and everything else coming up?
So the big picture is that we want to run in the midterms in several congressional races across the country. We want to get a representation in Congress, foothold in Congress, similar to the way that it was done when the Republican Party replaced the Whig Party in those first 2 years. That's what they did after forming as an official party. And then we want to use that, and we want to use the bully pulpit of Congress. You know, our members of Congress, when they get there, they're not going to give a damn about committee assignments. They're there to use the bully pulpit. They're there to actually put pressure. You know, it doesn't matter what, like, they're not going to be part of the Democratic caucus. Nancy Pelosi, you know, they don't want anything from her. And every single one of them is not going to equivocate on Medicare for All. They're for Medicare for All. There's no, like, middle ground. Yeah. And then we want to use that as a launching pad to run a presidential campaign in 2024 with ballot access across all 50 states. It's very doable. The Green Party, with almost no resources, has basically done it. The Libertarian Party has done it, you know, the past two times, with also virtually no resources. And so that is the big picture plan. And I'm happy to say that we are an official party now. We filed in our first state of Maine. And so we are registered as the People's Party. And next up, all the rest of the states. Particularly over the next year, we'll be getting ballot access everywhere.
So what congressional districts are you targeting?
So that's something we're still thinking about and looking for good districts. But some of the districts that we're thinking of going after are like these super deep blue districts where Bernie did really well in 2016 and 2020. And so it has a progressive leaning. And yet there's like this establishment corporate, you know, Democrat who's like held on to it for like a decade or two. You know, there's a bunch of districts like this where the Democrat is totally out of step with the district itself. But it's basically like a one party district because it's super gerrymandered blue. And so that means that we can come in as the People's Party and we can run against them as the second party in that district and have it be a referendum between the People's Party that actually stands for what everyone in that district believes in and is actually running people like community organizers, people who are rooted in the community, respected in the community, as opposed to that corporate like establishment politician who's been there forever and doesn't represent them.
Well, Ted Lieu is my congressman in my district in Santa Monica. If you guys want me to, I'll run against him.
Oh, amazing. We should definitely talk after the show, Graham.
All right. Because I'd love to unseat that guy. I'd love to. And it's a blue district. It's Santa Monica and Culver City. They're always going to vote blue. And I'd love to get him in a debate, man. All right. So what then? So basically you have to register in all 50 states. Is that the goal? You have Maine already done. You have to register in all 50 states and then you can have a national base to run like a president or whatever. How does that specifically work?
So you do have to register in all 50 states. Each of the states is, you know, has their own kind of like party system basically. And they have different requirements, you know, like you need to different signature levels that you need to get. Or register, or people who you need to register to the party. Like in California, it was 65,000. You know, that's probably gone up a little bit because it's like a fraction of the vote total in the last presidential election. And but it would be registering 65,000 people in California, for example. In Maine, we have to register 5,000 people to the party, and then we get official major party status and ballot access. So that will be basically the process. But we can run for president. I mean, we could run for president even if we didn't do that, but we intend to do that because it helps protect us and insulate us against Democratic Party efforts, the kind of which you saw during this past election, where they're trying to knock Howie Hawkins and the Greens off of the ballots. That's because they were going for candidate ballot access, but if we have a ballot line in those states, we're immune from that.
Okay. And so then you need these, like you say, in California, 65,000 people to sign a petition, or I'm sorry if I'm unclear on this.
Just register with the People's Party, just as you would become a member of a Democratic Party or the Republican Party.
Ah, so whenever you so you get your voter registration card in California, it has all the parties listed on there, but let's say People's Party isn't listed yet. You check other and put People's Party in there.
It will be an official option. And so once we file in California, we will have the official option of kind of checking People's Party, and people will be able to register with it officially on their on a voter registration form. And then once we get the required amount, we have an official ballot line. And so 65,000 in California, it's a piece of cake.
Done. And when the minute it's available for people to do it, please let me know and I'll start pushing it on this channel. I'll even have you back on or whatever we need to do to make that happen. I absolutely I became an elector for Jesse, for Draft Jesse. I'll do whatever is possible. And I really don't give a shit about the people in power at all. So, well, awesome. Okay. So then how then can people, for these long-term efforts, how can they get involved with the People's Party?
You can, we're building hubs across the country right now, chapters across the country, which are helping, they're going to start helping to get us on the ballot everywhere. And so they'll be collecting the registration signatures, for example, they'll be collecting signatures for ballot access. And so you can join us by volunteering at peoplesparty.org and head to the volunteer tab and join us there. You can also make a donation at peoplesparty.org. You can get involved in Force the Vote right now. These are all the ways that we have. And so we need everybody kind of building locally, because we're going to start building local party committees, state committees, and also organizing kind of efforts so that we can get on the ballot everywhere. And so that would be the biggest thing that everyone can do, is to help get us on the ballot and to help organize in your community just around, you know, issues that are happening you know, locally as well, not just national issues. And you can do that at peoplesparty.org.
Excellent. Well, folks, this is the thing I talk about. We're all scrambling, going, what do we do? How do I get involved? Well, this is a great place to get involved, is joining the People Party, get involved and Force the Vote. But also, this is a good long-term strategy of getting people and using a history book. It's the thing that drives me nuts when I'm listening to like AOC and the Squad. Oh, you can't, it's too performative. Like, have you ever cracked open a history book? Like, what do you think people did? Like, what do you think Rosa Parks, she worked for the NAACP and said, yeah, I'm going to take a seat. And my plan is to get arrested so that we get a lot of press. Like that's, they realized, oh, taking a seat up front, that's not going to change the laws. Not immediately. No, but it got people woken up, which is why we're still right. Talking about her, you know, 50, 60 years later. So this is the kind of movement, and it's all of us who are all fired up about Bernie and felt like we definitely got sheep herded by him twice, let's say it. And now he's just really good at tweeting. So this will be more than that, because as you said, and I've said it on this show, you have a better chance if you think you can reform the Democratic Party from within. I always say, go for it. You go join the Democratic Party. I'm going to join a drug cartel and get them to stop selling drugs and switch to vegan smoothies. And we'll see which one of us is more successful.
Right. Or I'm going to join Walmart and I'm going to try to reform that. Good idea. It's just like there are no in the Democratic Party. There are no institutional mechanisms for reform. The leadership isn't elected by the membership. Like, you know, The membership doesn't vote for the DNC chair, for example. You know, it's the donors basically who control the DNC members. There's like 100 lobbyists on the DNC, you know, and so it's just like a committee of corporations. Why in the hell would we expect it to do anything in our interest in the first place?
Which is a great thing. So let me ask you this. What things have you implemented in the creation and formation of the People's Party and its charter and everything like that to prevent that from happening, to prevent a bunch of corporate assholes? Let's say the People's Party wins these seats. The minute that then the corporate assholes are going to try to come in and go, oh, I'm on your side or whatever. So how do you guys prevent that from how you started it?
Well, to run with us, you're going to have to agree to our platform and to our principles, you know, and chief among those is you don't take corporate money.
I'm out. I'm Nick. I'm huge corporate money. I take money from the vegan smoothie lobby and Big Kale. And I don't know if I could handle. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
That was the first thing at the People's Convention, which you were at, which we enshrined. It was the first vote that we took. We had more than 1 million viewers for the People's Convention. And we voted at the conclusion of the convention with all of the amazing people who joined us there on whether we wanted to form a major new political party in America that is free of corporate money and influence. And that vote passed by 99% of the people who cast votes. And so that's a pretty damn big mandate. And so that's one of the things automatically, no revolving door. If you've been involved in industry, you know, if you've been an industry executive, you know, you can't come in and hold these party leadership positions. You can't come in and run on our ballot line. That's not going to happen. Also, we're going to have elected leadership at all different levels, state, national, county, and membership will actually be voting, unlike it does in the Democratic Party. So those are some of the ways. And also next year, we're going to be creating our national charter as well. So we'll be enshrining all of these different things into it.
Excellent. Folks, you're here watching The Political Vigilante with Nick Brana. Please hit the like button and share. We have over 800 people watching. Make sure you hit the like button. If you're new to my show, please hit the subscribe button. Speaking of big corporations, YouTube is throttling channels like mine. So you hitting the subscribe button very much helps out this show. So thanks for watching, everybody. Please hit the like button, the subscribe button. Go to patreon.com/Graham Elwood and rockfin.com/Graham Elwood, where you can support the show. Also, I have a Bitcoin wallet, a Bitcoin Cash wallet, and an Ethereum wallet in the show notes. We're taking cryptocurrency. I have a Coinbase affiliation link. We're going to be getting on some other exchanges. So that's how you support the show. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. YouTube is unsubscribing us at an alarming rate. I have a PayPal button at grahamelwood.com. I even have a Venmo at graham-elwood. There's a lot of ways to support our show. We are getting crushed by YouTube. We've dipped under 73,000 subscribers because of YouTube. Thanks for supporting what we do.